You can't go wrong when you're trying to be strong. I didn't even have to write down the words of this song. Freakness is my only weakness. Strength is never a weakness. I fear no man. I feel no pain. I have no sorrow. A violent attack today is better than a well-planned attack tomorrow. This is Mark Bell from supertraining.tv, Super Training Gym, the strongest gym in the West, answering more questions today for the Freakin' Power Project, brought to you by HowMuchBench.net, the Slingshot, and the only strength magazine in the world, thepowermagazine.com. I got a question today from my brother, Chris. He's about yay big. And he has a question about the squat. My brother is someone who's stiff. A lot of powerlifters get stiff over the years. That's one of the inherent problems with powerlifting, is you end up with some really stiff tissues and stiff issues. But he has a hard time getting underneath the barbell for his squats. And this is a very common problem that we see. Actually, when I see lifters do a squat, I take somebody through a squat in a seminar, a lot of times they'll perform the squat perfectly. Then I'll put a barbell on their back and they'll have trouble. The reason for that is there's a lot of problems in the upper body that people don't account for when they're doing a squat. A lot of the dysfunction that you're going to see is actually going to come more so from the belly button up than it is from the belly button down. You would think if it's a squat, it has to do with all legs and all hips and kind of how you control your hips and how you force your knees out and so on. And some of that's true. But we see a lot of problem in the upper back right here. You can see he's got some mass here, bigger, stronger, faster. When he goes to put his arms back, there's just a lot of stuff here. And then he's also very tight through the front, through the breasticles here. And some things that he can do before he does his workout. I thought he was going to stay backwards the whole time like Macho Man. Before he does his workout, it's going to be the most important time for him to get into those tissues and get himself warm. So first things first is he would have to get himself warmed up. So doing some bench press would be a good idea. Also doing some flies. Incline flies are going to provide a little bit more stretch than a flat dumbbell fly. And also just kind of holding those positions. You're not actually really performing flies, not really looking for a pump. We're actually looking for the opposite of that. We're just looking to kind of stretch out all the muscle and all the tissue so that our arms can work a little bit more efficiently for the day. I'd recommend using very light weights for that, 10 pounds, 15 pounds, maybe as high as 20. And stretching, you know, one side, kind of then the other, holding two dumbbells. But you can kind of do it in an unorthodox way. There's really no wrong or right way. You're gonna wanna stretch for about 2 minutes. You can also do some bench presses, some uneven bench presses with just a barbell. Bring a weight down and have the other arm extended. Bring the bar down all crooked like this and really let it get into those tissues and really let that shoulder drop and keep rotating it in here and do the other side as well. Some simple shoulder warm-ups would help also, just some band pull-aparts and some things like that. Now the real issue is, in a squat, we want to try to carry the bar as low as possible. Most of the greatest squats of all time, the highest squats of all time, are usually done with a low bar position, and so that's usually what we're trying to look for. That being said, that's going to be more strain and more stress on the shoulders. What I would suggest is in your warm-ups, in your workout, I would just say,
where do you want the bar? Where should it be?
I would say keep the bar high for a few sets and then work the bar down. But this kind of goes back to my principle of, you know, there's nothing wrong with doing the exercise right. You're not going to go to jail. You're not going to go to hell. Do the exercise right. Learn how to do the exercise and even get the exercise executed properly for that day, no matter who you are, how talented or how gifted you are or how gifted you're not in lifting, get the exercise down for that particular day. So he could take the bar multiple times until he starts to really feel warm, and he could start to add some weight until he starts to feel a little bit better. But some of those things are going to help, and then obviously him getting into some of these stiff tissues with the Supernova that Kelly Starrett has from roguefitness.com would be a good idea.
What is that?
The Supernova is just a giant ball, basically, and you can kind of dig into the shoulders, dig into some of the muscles of the upper back. That'll help a lot. Some foam rolling will help as well. But really stretching with weights is going to be almost what you need because your body is just too stiff to really try any other type of stretching. Last but not least would be to stretch with bands and try to stretch the lats, stretch your chest with bands. You can look all that stuff up online. There's a lot of information on it. You can go to mobilitywad.com, which is owned by my boy Kelly Starrett, and there's a lot of different types of stretches there. You can also just YouTube and Google rotator cuff stretches. That's going to help you get underneath that barbell a little bit better. One more thing is to take your thumb off the bar. A lot of times when your thumb is on the bar, you can see here, go ahead and pull your wrist back as hard as you can. So there isn't shit going on here with this wrist. This is terrible. And look at how bad the shoulder is. He wants to like collapse to the ground basically. I'm the same way, if not worse. I can only do this. And so by taking the thumb off the barbell, there's gonna be less stress here on the wristicles, be less stress here on the wrist, and he's gonna be able to have a little bit lower bar position. The weight, he'll feel the weight more on his back than he will feel on his wrist. It's not dangerous. Well, lifting weights is dangerous, so if you wanna get out of the danger game, you're gonna have to stop lifting weights.
All right, see you later.
But strength is never a weakness, and that is it from supertraining.tv.